the book, what the Quran book is, Allah says about the book. Surah Ali Imran 3 and Ayah 7. هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ مِنْهُ آيَاتٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ هُنَّ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ وَأُخَرُ مُتَشَابِهَاتٌ. And it is He who has revealed Al-Kitab, the book, over you. In it are muhkamat, governing ayat, signs. These are the mother of Al-Kitab, the book. And others are mutashabihat, resembling ayat, signs. We will discuss this ayah in portions. For example, the first little portion I read again. هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. It is He who has revealed over you the book. So I have already explained to you the meaning, the book. So the book is the written one. So Allah is telling us, it is He who has revealed over you, the messenger, the book, the written one, this book. So the book was revealed on him. The written one was revealed on him. هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. It is He who has revealed Al-Kitab, the book, over you. مِنْهُ آيَةٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ. In the book, from the book. From the book are ayats, the verses, the signs. مُحْكَمَاتٌ, governing ayats. In the book, from the book, there are ayats, signs, that are muhkamat, governing ayas. Hunna ummul kitab. They are the mother of the book. Wa ukharu mutashabihat. And the others are resembling ayas. They are the two types of ayat. So first we will, in this book, for example, if you look into this, there are two types of ayas. The muhkamat ayat, the governing ayas, and the other ayat, the mutashabihat or resembling ayas. So we'll see what are the muhkamat ayats first, and then we will see what are the resembling ayats. What are the muhkamat ayat, the governing ayats, and what are the mutashabit or resembling ayats. To understand, we go to the next page, we come back again, but we first go to the next page, and we see what are the muhkamat ayat. In Surah Al-Ma'idah 5 and Ayah 43, وَكَيْفَ يُحَكِّمُونَكَ وَعِنْدَهُمُ التَّوْرَةَ فِيهَا حُكْمُ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّوْنَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَٰلِكَ وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And how can they govern you? And at Torah, the law is near them. In it is the hukum, the government of Allah. Then after that they turn away, they are not with the believers. Now, the word you see here, is, Allah says, how can they govern you? How can they govern you? That the at Torah, the law, is near them. They have got the law with them. In the law, in the Torah, or the Torah, fiha hukmullah. So in the Torah, the law, Allah says, is the hukum of Allah, the government of Allah, that the governing ayat of Allah, the government of Allah. So we come to know from this ayat that the ayats that are contained, the orders or the governing ayats, is the government of Allah, hukm Allah, in the Torah. Torah means the law. I hold in my hand is Al-Kitab. And in this Al-Kitab, the muhkamat ayat, the governing ayat, is the Torah. And that Torah is the mother of the book. That Torah becomes the mother of this book, Al-Kitab. All the governing ayats by which we have to govern ourselves, that is the muhkamat ayat, and they are the mother of the book. For example, I tell you that if you say we have to establish the salah, that is a muhkam ayat, the governing ayat. We have to govern ourselves that we have to establish the salah. That's the governing ayat. We have to perform hajj. That's the governing ayat. We have to govern ourselves that the hajj. Then we have to give sadqa, the charity, that is the governing ayat, that the muhkam ayat, muhkamat ayat, muhkam means governing. And then you have to fast, that's also governing ayat, that's the muhkam ayat. So all the ayats that are governing you, that are the muhkamat ayat. And they are the mother of the book, same book. They are the mother of the book. And Allah has named that book, that governing ayat, as the Torah, the law. Now we come to the other part, that is the وَأُخَرُوا مُتَشَابِهَاتٌ. And the others are resembling ayahs, that ayahs that resemble, to explain, to understand. I'm reading portion, then we'll read the whole ayah. Then we come to, you open the page number, next page, it's Az-Zumar, page number 5 and 6, Az-Zumar 39 and ayah 23. Allahu nazzala ahsal hadith kitabam mutashabim matani, and Allah has revealed the most beautiful hadith, the event, a book mutashabiha, resembling, repeating itself. Allahu nazzala ahsal hadith. Allah has revealed the most beautiful hadith, or the event, or the narration, the most beautiful narration, hadith and event. Kitab, kitabam mutashabi masani. Kitab means the written one or a book. Mutashabi means resembling. Masani means repeating. So now, what previous ayat we read, waqaru mutashabiyat, that portion, Surah Al-Imran 3:7 ayat. The others are mutashabi, resembling ayat. And here Allah is explaining that the book contains, the other aspect of the ayat is the Allahu nazzala asan hadith. Hadith in Arabic means event and narration. And that narration and events is written down in this book. They are resembling, mutashabiya, and repeating. So ladies and gentlemen, who have read the Quran, they will note very, very carefully that in the ayahs of Allah, that there are governing ayahs. Establish the salah, for example. Give zakah is the governing ayahs. And there are events about Adam. There are events. And there are about Musa salam event. Hal ataka hadithu Musa, has not reached you the event of Musa, peace be upon him. That is the event. Then there is the event of Jannah. Any event, or how the world came into existence, how the rain comes onto the ground. Any event described in the ayahs of Allah are the mutashabiya, resembling ayahs. Any event, events of Ibrahim al-Islam, event of Yusuf al-Islam, event of Musa al-Islam, and the event of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. They are the hadith and events of all the prophets, including Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the seal of the prophets. They are the mutashabiyat ayat, or the resembling ayats. When there is an order or the hukum, is the governing ayats, where you have to guard your life, you have to govern yourself. And when you read the events of various prophets, or various about the skies and the and anything, that is the mutashabiyat ayat. This is Allah has divided and described within His book of Allah. We have come here to listen to what the Quran has to say about the book. So the book, Allah says in the book, there are two types of ayahs. One is the muhkam ayat, the governing ayahs. The other is the mutashabiyat, the resembling ayahs. And in the resembling ayahs, I am explaining to you, there are many, many resembling ayahs, or the events that resemble each other. They are repeated also. Adam alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Nuh alayhi salam, the event is narrated, and sometimes it is paused, and after other surahs, then again the event start, again is repeated. So ayahs related to one event is repeated again and again. So the ayahs that are the resembling ayahs are keep on repeating within the Quran. So these are the two types of ayahs within the book, Al-Kitab.